Welcome to another episode of Simmer Clips. Today's question is related to our flagship course, server-side tagging in Google Tag Manager, and here is the question. How do I set up a same origin deployment in server-side Google Tag Manager? In server-side Google Tag Manager, you typically have two deployment options. One is to use a subdomain, like tagging.mydomain.com, and the other is to use same origin, which means that you set up server-side Google Tag Manager in a subfolder of your website. So if your website is www.cmohave.com, then server-side GTM could be deployed in www.cmohave.com-measure, for example. The biggest benefit of a same origin setup is that it gives you tools for prolonging cookie lifetimes on the Safari browser, for example. It makes it easier to maintain cache rules, and you don't have to worry about cross-origin resource sharing or course issues as much. And even a content security policy might be easier to maintain. While I don't recommend one over the other, a subdomain setup is far easier. And in the Simmer course, server-side tagging Google Tag Manager, we talk about a subdomain setup in detail. However, a same origin setup is very popular and it has its benefits, even if it is a bit more involved and it does require specialist technology and services to deploy. In this Simmer Clips video, we're going to talk about how to set up same origin using Cloudflare, which does offer a free option with some limitations for setting up a same origin setup. So let's see how that all works. Before you deploy the same origin setup, you do need an existing server-side tagging deployment. And in this case, I have server-side tagging running in Google Cloud Run, and it's currently routed through a load balancer that answers with a routing rule to a subdomain of cmohave.com. So this subdomain exists currently solely for the load balancer itself, and I'm going to create the subfolder or the same origin rule in Cloudflare to direct all traffic to the measure folder to this subdomain. That's how I make sure that even though we're using a same origin setup, it still goes through the load balancer I configured in the Google Cloud platform. If you're not using a load balancer, you can direct the same origin setup directly to the default public URL that Google Cloud platform gives to all Cloud Run deployments. But in this case, we are already using a load balancer, which I do recommend everybody set up in Cloud Run. And we have a subdomain mapped to a static IP address in front of that load balancer. Another thing that is required for this all to work is that you need to have a Cloudflare setup that's proxying your main website domain. So if your main website domain isn't behind Cloudflare, you can't set up Cloudflare because you have to have your website DNS managed by Cloudflare. In this case, cmohave.com and www.cmohave.com are already managed by Cloudflare and proxied, which is the yellow cloud you see here. So I can confidently set up the same origin deployment. If you follow the official documentation, it actually recommends you set up the same origin setup using rules. So you would go to Cloudflare, under rules, you would create a new origin rule. The problem with this approach is that in order to set the host header, which is required for first-party cookies to be transferred, for example, it requires the enterprise plan in Cloudflare. And instead, I want to show you how to do everything using the free plan, which is more accessible to everyone. And to set up the free plan, we actually need to create a worker. A worker is a piece of code running on the edge, which is basically the name of the technology that Cloudflare uses to redirect internet traffic. And it can be used to trigger off certain HTTP patterns, for example. So whenever a request comes in for cmohave.com-measure, which is where I want the server-side GTM to respond with, I can use a worker that captures that request, then starts forwarding information to Google Tag Manager, for example, and responds back to the browser accordingly. So we need to create a new worker for this whole thing to work. And to create a worker, we go to the add menu, and then we go to workers. And if you don't have any workers yet, it will force you to use a template. So we're going to just start with the Hello World option here. Let's give the worker a descriptive name, something like this. This doesn't really matter because you're not going to be using the public URL for the worker at all. And then we're going to click deploy just to get finally to a place where we can edit the code itself. Now that we have deployed our worker, we can start editing its code. And the first thing we'll do is just delete all the code that was there before. And in this JavaScript file, we're going to write all the logic, what should happen when a request comes into the www.cmohave.com domain with the path measure. And we want to forward all of those requests to our server-side tagging endpoint. And remember that you can find all of this code in the accompanying blog article, and you'll find a link to the blog article in the video notes. So we're going to start with this export default block, and this basically instructs the worker what the default behavior is. And within that block, we're going to overwrite the fetch request. So whenever an HTTP request comes in, this fetch request is triggered, and this is where all the magic happens, where we process the incoming request from the website, forward the data to server-side GTM, and then return the response back to the browser. Here we have our first processing logic in place. On line 3, we create a reference to the actual request URL. So this is what the browser sent. This could be a Google Analytics 4 request or a request for the GTM container, a request for a metapixel or Stapes data tag, for example. So with this, we create a reference to the original URL. Then we build a request upstream. So this is where we want to forward the incoming request to. So this would be your server-side GTM endpoint. And here you need to make some changes. For example, on line 5, I have decided the measure is going to be the path name that my same origin setup responds to. If you want that path name to be SST or tracking or ZYX, for example, you need to change this string here to something else that matches the path name that you chose. On line 6, you need to make sure that the new URL constructor contains a reference to your server-side tagging endpoint. So if you're using Cloud Run with a basic deployment of one backend, this would be the Cloud Run public path, or whatever technology you're using, this would be a public path to your server-side Google Tag Manager. On line 10, we build a configuration object for the request that we are forwarding to server-side GTM. And in this configuration object, we copy the request method from the incoming request. So if it was a GET request or a POST request, we copy that method name into the request that we're sent to server-side GTM. We copy all the headers from the incoming request to the request to server-side GTM. This is absolutely vital in case you want to forward cookies or authentication tokens or something like that. We copy the body only if the request method supports a body. So if the request method was a GET request or a HEAD request, for example, we don't add a body to the outgoing request because obviously those requests wouldn't have a body. But if it was a POST request, for example, we would copy the body into the outgoing request. And then we add a redirection instruction as well. On line 19, we need to make some changes to the headers. So as I just mentioned, we do copy all the headers of the incoming request and forward them to server-side GTM, but we can't send a host header because workers can't change the host header of outgoing fetch requests. So we need to use a custom header name. In this case, it's X-forwarded host and X-forwarded proto for host and protocol, respectively. And server-side GTM does know how to read these. So it doesn't find the host header because we actually delete that from the outgoing request so that we don't throw any errors. It does know how to read X-forwarded host. And this header is important because this is the header that server-side GTM uses to determine on which domain to write cookies. So now that we are forwarding the original request host, server-side GTM will be able to set the cookies correctly. Importantly, on line 22, we also set a cache control header instructing that no request should be cached. And this is very important when using Cloudflare because Cloudflare is first and foremost an edge caching machine. So it stores requests temporarily to speed up the internet. We don't want anything to be stored. We don't want analytics requests or requests for Google Tag Manager to be stored beyond what the services themselves require. So that's why this cache control header is important to set. On line 24, we build the actual request to server-side GTM. So here we use the fetch again, and we send a request to the upstream URL, which you configured earlier in the code, and we add the entire request configuration object as an argument to the fetch method. And finally, once the fetch returns a response, which is now stored in the constant variable upstream RISP, on line 26, we return a new response, HTTP response, back to the browser, which uses the body from the response from server-side GTM, the status code, for example, 200, 413, 400, 500, whatever server-side GTM responds, the status text, and then all the headers from the response. And again, this headers is very important because we want to forward all set cookie headers back to the browser. Once you have all this code in place, it's time to deploy again. So click deploy in the top right corner and it shouldn't take long. Once you've deployed, you can go back to the worker page, then head over to settings, and in domains and routes, we need to add a new route rule. So whenever requests comes in for a certain path, we want to trigger this worker. We can also disable the default public URL of the worker while we're at it. Next, we're going to add the route here, and it's going to be a URL pattern that is mapped to the worker. For the zone, choose your Cloudflare zone where your main domain is being proxied, and then add the route here. So in this case, it's going to be like this. So it is my domain name that is being proxied through Cloudflare DNS with the path that I chose for my server-side GTM same origin deployment and an asterisk, which means that all requests to that path will trigger the worker and then the outgoing fetch request. Once done, click Add Route and make sure that it shows up here in the routes. You've basically completed the Cloudflare setup now, so now it's time to test. The first thing I'm going to do is go to my web container, find my Google Analytics 4 configuration, and here, make sure there's a server container URL field now set to the same origin folder that you built in Cloudflare Workers, like this. Click Save here. In server-side Google Tag Manager, I am going to go to Admin and Container Settings. And here I am going to change the server container URL to the subfolder again. If you recall, this setting only affects preview mode, but it's still good to have it there so you don't have to manually change the URL every time you go to preview. Let's first go to preview mode in server-side GTM, and this is kind of a litmus test, did everything work? When I click preview, it should open server-side GTM preview mode in the subfolder of my main website domain. Fingers crossed, let's see what happens. Here you can see the domain cmohava.com with the subfolder measure, and then preview mode seems to work beautifully. Next, I'm going to go preview mode in my web container, which now has the new GA4 outbound URL. And now when I go to server-side GTM debug mode, I should see requests for GA4 here. As you can see, they're coming in. So the GA4 requests are being forwarded correctly to my subfolder. And now let's check if the cookies are being set correctly. So first of all, here you can see that the request does include cookies. So cookies are being forwarded from the website to server-side GTM. And the response has a set cookie value for the FPID, for example, the first party identifier used by GA4, set correctly on the cmohava.com domain. Now, when I open the website itself and check requests to GA4, I can see that they're correctly sent to the subfolder. And then in the response, I can see the set cookie header correctly setting the cookie on my domain. So this is how a same origin setup using Cloudflare works. You basically just need a single worker JavaScript file doing all the hard work for you. Just note that the free Cloudflare plan sets some limitations on workers. They can process basically 100,000 requests per day for free, which might be a problem on larger websites. So if you have a larger website, you might need to upgrade to a more robust Cloudflare plan. And if you're using Cloudflare Enterprise, you can actually do the whole thing without workers, just following the official instructions for how to set up those origin and host rules. But for smaller sites like my blog, this works wonderfully as a same origin setup. But you can also use the traditional subdomain setup, which doesn't require any Cloudflare shenanigans at all. You can just set up your subdomain using Google Cloud Platform with a static external IP address and then some DNS updates. I hope this video was helpful in understanding how a same origin setup can be configured for server-side Google Tag Manager.